Hello everyone, welcome to the new session of the VoLTE end-to-end training campaign. In today's video, we are going to continue with the VoLTE related features part. As you remember, in previous sessions, we covered this feature, which is starting from TTI bundling till we reach into this exit DRX based on SNR. In today's video, we are going to cover those four highlighted features. And next session will be the last one. We'll be covering the remaining feature related to the orange highlighted one. So let's see what we have today. The first feature we're going to cover today is called PUSCH Uplink Resource Block Reservation. This is, can have a different naming between one vendor to another. But the idea of this feature is very simple. The idea of this feature that you can reserve a particular PUSCH resources to be used only by VoLTE users. It will be only reserved for VoLTE users and to be only used by them. So what is the gain of such, what can kind of be expected and what kind of drawbacks? So if you look into the figure below here, this is like the different cells, and this was the uplink interference for the resource blocks, allocated resource blocks. If you look into this particular area, the red one, you can see that there is high uplink interference at those particular resource blocks here. So if the VoLTE users being occupied those particular resources, this might cause a voice quality issues and might impact your MOS, right? And voice quality in general. So VoLTE is more sensitive to the interference compared to the data. So this feature, you can look into, for example, the allocated resource blocks for those particular cells. And you can, for example, you see this area is the best area. You can reserve, for example, three resource blocks to be used only by VoLTE users. And once those resource block is being exhausted or occupied, still the VoLTE users can use the remaining resource blocks, but at least you would ensure that as a start point, they will be using the clean band or clean resources. And those resources also will never be used by data. So this resource will all the time being clean because there will be no any transmission from data users across the same resource blocks. And the drawbacks of that part for sure, that as long as you're reserving those for VoLTE users only, so this is might impact your peak throughput in general for the uplink, because this would be all the time reserved for VoLTE users and cannot be used by data users. So the main recommendation usually for such features to be used as a scenario based, for example, to use it for a particular cells where you have high link uplink interference and you would like to reserve a particular resources for those users. Also, there is another scenario where you have huge congestion, for example, in the cells, and you don't want like to impact the VoLTE users, so you reserve some resources for them. This is just scenarios. So usually this is like a scenario based. It's not being recommended to be done complete network as an example. As you can see here, there is a clear gain in packet loss and block error rate once there was some resource being reserved for VoLTE. Also, the voice quality has been improved, as you can see here. So this is very simple feature, and the name of the feature can be different from one vendor to another. So let's move to the next feature. The next one, actually, it's also very simple. It's mainly as written from the name here. You can see it's called disable carrier aggregation for VoLTE users. For example, if you already have 4G carrier aggregation being operating, so you still can have VoLTE in the same time. So the VoLTE during the call, you can have a carrier aggregation. So why usually the operator recommend, or in general, it's being recommended to disable carrier aggregation? Actually, this is because during the carrier aggregation, you can have some impact which might impact your call drop rate, especially for VoLTE. As you know, that press all the carrier aggregation in general, it requires the ENDC require all the time to deliver the A1, A2, A6 reports, which related to the carrier aggregation addition and removal and carrier aggregation cell change, for example, secondary cell change. So, for example, those require to be delivered by the ENDC. So, if you have more carriers, you require more RRCP configuration. So, this kind of repetition or repetitive RR series configuration, this is might lead into sometimes into RR series establishment if the user is in a poor radio condition, in case if the user didn't receive the RR series configuration message. Also, in general, if you have multiple carrier aggregation, let's assume two or three carrier aggregation or four, you require a repetitive SSL configuration, right? Even addition or removal. So this is also can have the same situation where the users during the call trying to add a secondary cell or third cell, or trying to configure some of the carrier aggregation cells, and somehow there is some failures in that. So this increasing the probability that we'll have an RRC establishment, which might lead into drop as well. And the third part, in case if you have as shown here, uplink aggregation being enabled, not only downlink. So in case of uplink aggregation, this is actually will cause a power limitation, because usually the user need to use, for each carrier, it needs to transmit the different power. For example, as I will be highlighting in the next slide, for example, if you have a 23 dB maximum power, so the power need to transmit it between to be split between the two carriers, so the power will reduce by 3 dB. It will be around 20 dB, and assume also you have three carriers, it will be go even to 17 dB. So the uplink aggregation general will limit the uplink coverage, uplink transmitted coverage for the users. So this also can be reflected in the coverage. That's why usually it's being recommended to enable, to disable, sorry, the carrier aggregation during using the VoLTE calls. Let's try to get a figure about this particular area where we have uplink, how it will like try to visualize how the power will be split, as mentioned here. So in general, this will be reflected mostly in the VoLTE call drop rate. Okay, as you can see in the figure on the right here, this is assuming that this is the transmission from the U side, and this is the UTX branches. You have two TX branches. The maximum power is 23 dB. And the main idea that you have one carrier for 4G and secondary carrier. So the user now to need to split the power of the 23. So he will send 20 here and 20 here. So this is actually will be reflecting into a less power for this particular users. Even though the max is 23, because the power is being split, he lost around 3 dB. And even though if he went for more three carriers, this is will reduce even more, and also for four carriers will be reduced for more as well. But this is mainly for uplink, and usually even if uplink you have it enabled in the network, usually the maximum supported by the users is two, and I think usually it's rarely being used in general. But this is just from theoretical background. So this was showing an impact from the one of the networks. For example, you can see there is this simulation for one of the networks. As you can see, there is a good improvement of VoLTE drop rate after the aggregation was being disabled. And you might not see this in different, like if you implemented in your network, you might see this. This depend on the network situation in general, user location, and many other aspects. For example, how many carrier aggregation you have in the network. But in general, it's being recommended to disable the carrier aggregation for VoLTE users. So let's move to the next feature. Actually, the next feature is, you can say it's exactly, or the next parameter is exactly the same concept as the carrier aggregation. It's for the NSA users. If you have 5G NSA or ENDC, it's also being recommended to disable that. Why? Because the first point again, which we just being highlighted, the power will be split between one leg being transmitted for 4G and one leg for 5G NSA. So again, you will lost around 3 dB. So this is limiting your uplink coverage. And this is the main reason actually, because this is limiting your uplink coverage. So in this case, it's not recommended to enable the ENDC for the VoLTE user, so you not required to have this kind of splitting, or in general ENDC being allowed for VoLTE users, you need required to go for this scenario. Also another scenario that sometimes this kind of ENDC addition, it require signaling, so there might some interference between the signal interference or race condition, or in other words, the procedures or process of the signaling of the, you know, the call setup of the VoLTE also being conflicted with ENDC. So maybe in some vendors, you will have this kind of conflict that will prioritize, for example, the ENDC addition over the VoLTE. So this is, might lead into, for example, a call setup issue for the VoLTE. But I think this issue is being, usually the vendor address this issue through that prioritizing the VoLTE signaling over the ENDC. So the main limitation is about losing the doubling coverage. You will lose around 3 dB. In case if you are using ENDC for VoLTE users, so it's also being recommended to disable the ENDC for the user in order to improve your drop rate. So this is exactly or similar to the carrier aggregation scenario, which being highlighted in the previous slide. Now let's jump to the last feature. Actually, the last feature, it's not particularly related to the VoLTE, but it's just like it can also be benefit for VoLTE. I have quoted these pictures from ShareTechnote. You can go there for check through, take note. I will add the link in the video description. It's having even more details and very good details about the same particular thing. The main idea of the hopping in general, PUSCH hopping, this is can be having a very good improvement because doing something called frequency diversity. So let's just explain from the beginning. If you look into this figure without hopping, you can see this is, for example, the subband, which is the frequencies domain, and this is the time domain. subframes and so on, you can see that all the resources being allocated, for example, at subband zero or whatever resource block zero, whatever you can call it, it's being allocated here all over the frame. So there is no change throughout the frame allocation. The resources are not being changed. And in case if you have a frequency impairment, you have interference at this particular area, for example, at subband zero, so in this case, you would be interfered all the time. That this where the frequency hopping can get some gain in case of the frequency allocation of frequency of the frequency hopping. For example, if you look into this picture, you will find that the first subframe, the resource being allocated here, and the second subframe, it's being allocated a different subband on different source block. So this is making like a frequency diversity, which accordingly can be reflected in your quality and accordingly can be reflected in your coverage. So it can improve the packet loss and even the quality in general, the voice quality in general, which is the most. This is the main idea. And there is two types of the hopping, which is inter-subframe, as you can see, which will be the frequency allocation would be each subframe, as you can see, change at each subframe. And there is intra-subframe. For example, here, the first part is being here, and the second slot, for example, is being allocated in the second slot is being allocated in different resource blocks. And again, the main idea that this is increasing the frequency diversity and can be reflected in packet loss. But this is actually cannot mitigate such issues because you are not expecting that you will have a clean band whenever you do a frequency hopping, right? Because this is not a frequency selective. Frequency selective, if you remember, we discussed about it before, is selecting the location of the resource blocks based on the quality, correct? So this is like frequency hopping in general, like for sure the frequency selective, it will be more beneficial in terms of this particular scenario because it will selecting the clean resource blocks from the beginning. So this case actually can mitigate, but it cannot completely eliminate because again, you might have this kind of impairment frequency in for example, in subband three, whenever the allocation is being done. So yeah, so this was the main idea of the today features. Next part, we'll cover the last features and we'll try to close this training. I hope if you like the video content to press like and share it with your friends and to spread the word. Thank you and see you next session.